people in Bristol tend to think we're pretty forward-thinking, pretty progressive, but in reality, there's 45 arms companies linked to Bristol, with Elbit being the centrepiece of this trial, because they were the target of the Palestine activists, smashed up all their equipment. But Elbit is just one of 45 companies around Bristol, and they are linked to the Ministry of Defence site in Abbeywood. And Abbeywood supplies a lot of the training, logistics, arms, munitions that have ended up killing untold how many people in the Yemen war, the Saudi war against the Yemenis people, which was backed by the United States and Britain. I managed to collar a fella from the Palestine Solidarity Campaign, and he's going to give a little word on this.
Roland Dye, Dr. Roland Dye, if that's important. I'm also the secretary of Bristol Palestine Solidarity Campaign. Well, this feels a very historic trial that Palestine Action have come to Bristol and exposed Elbit, which is Israel's biggest armed company, very brave to smash their way into the building and occupy it and end up here at the Crown Court for a jury trial. And maybe this is opening everybody's eyes to the fact that Bristol, rather shockingly, has got a massive arms industry. There's at least 30 arms companies scattered across the North Bristol fringe. Historically, that's because an aircraft industry grew up here in the 1920s, supplying planes to the British, who were wanting to police their empire. It took 10 years to bomb Kurdistan into submission. The RAF invented everything nasty you could drop out of a plane onto the people on the ground. And once that was successful, it enabled Britain then to control other parts of their vast empire. This is a shocking history, but it sowed the seeds of the arms industry here in North Bristol. Then the MOD, the gigantic £10 billion a year of our taxpayers' money to spend on weapons, moved to North Bristol, built in Abbey Wood in the mid-90s, and all these other companies have grown up. And then, of course, links with both universities, which are complicit in various ways. There's companies that are making parts for the F-35 fighter bombers, which are bombing Gaza at the moment. And Elbit, rather unfortunately, have just now announced very proudly they're opening a £50 million factory, also up in North Bristol, possibly to manufacture drones. And of course, Elbit have got very good quality drones. They know they're good because they use Gaza as a test laboratory for all their weaponry. Then they can sell their stuff around the rest of the world as battle tested at a higher price. So this is shocking. We really don't want this in Bristol. Bristol, the city that likes to stand on the right side of history, the four brave young people who pulled down the Colston statue and opened people's eyes to the shocking history of Britain's slave trade. And Bristol says no to the slave trade, needs to say no to the arms trade. Thank you very much.